Step 3. Taxes and other deductions. Sam was eager to learn about taxes. Well, perhaps not eager. Sam wanted to understand them a bit better. He didn't want to have to pay fines. He wondered again why he hadn't learned more about this at school. He had come prepared and he had questions. So he asked finance wizard Dave, "Should I pay taxes?" Dave chuckled. Was the question, "Do I need to or do I have to?" He decided to answer both. Yes, you should pay taxes. There is a progressive tax system, meaning people that earn more pay a bigger portion of their salary. Taxes go to help the country function. Without them, we wouldn't have roads and other infrastructure. This made sense to Sam. He also thought it was fair that people who earned more paid more. The second part of the question was, did Sam have to pay taxes? Dave explained that Sam had to pay national insurance because he was earning more than $8,000 at 12%, and personal tax at 20% because he was earning more than $11,000. Below these amounts are tax-free, so you only pay on what you earn above these. Dave also mentioned that the amount is spread over a year, and as Sam only just started, this would be spread over fewer months, and he was likely to pay a little bit more tax next year. Sam then asked nervously, "So, do I have to submit a tax return?" Dave responded reassuringly. The first thing to remember is that the tax authority wants you to pay taxes, so they try to make it as easy as possible and generally do a pretty good job. So for a lot of people, they don't need to submit a return. Sam asked, hopefully again, if he was one of those people. So Sam and Dave went through the flags, such as being self-employed, giving to charity, having investments such as property, or simply if they ask you to. Once they had gone through all of them, Sam responded cheerfully that he didn't need to complete a tax return. Dave further explained that Sam needn't worry if he had to submit a return in the future. The tax authority makes it as easy as they can, and unless you meet lots of criteria making your situation complex, it is easy enough to complete a return in 30 to 60 minutes. Otherwise, it may be worth hiring someone to help you, especially the first time. Dave gave Sam the list of flags and a link to the video explaining how to submit a return. He noted that the key dates for setting up an online account were 5th of October, so Sam would have 6 months after the tax year ended in early April. He would also have until the 31st of January the following year, or 10 months to complete his return. Sam thought that he would do it much earlier than that, in case he needed help. Sam and Dave then inputted in the workbook all the other amounts coming off his pay, including a pension contribution and student loan payment. Dave noticed that the pension amount was lower than he had hoped for, and made a mental note to go through that with Sam later.